time travel!
Hey, Hot Fam. Today, I'll be taking you with me to one of the most haunted houses in America, the Whaley House, located in Old Town San Diego. I'm going to be giving you a brief history of the home, its location, and the role of the Whaley family in the community, as well as some spooky ghost stories along the way. This is a little different than my typical family travel vlogs, but I just love the Whaley House and I wanted to share more of it with you. If this sounds fun to you, then let's get into the video. Thomas Whaley was born in New York in October of 1823. He learned his entrepreneurial spirit from his father, and in 1849 he headed west to partake in the California Gold Rush. After finding success in the California Gold Rush and setting up various businesses in San Diego, Thomas Whaley earned enough money to return to New York and marry his love, Anna Louise. After they were married, Thomas and Anna returned to San Diego, and that is when Thomas Whaley purchased the land to build his beautiful family home. This two-story Greek Revival house was designed by Thomas Whaley. He began construction in May of 1856. He was determined to make his new home the handsomest, most comfortable, and convenient place in town. And it was. The Whaley House played a major role in the community of Old Town San Diego. Not only did Thomas Whaley build a family home, but he also built a community gathering place that served as a commercial theater, a courthouse, and a bilingual general store. Thomas and Anna Whaley went on to have six children together: Francis, Thomas, Anna Amelia, George, Violet, and Corinne. The Whaley House also served as the county courthouse in 1869. $65 a month, the county of San Diego leased a courtroom and three upstairs bedrooms. Before it was a courthouse, this room served as a grain storeroom, and then it was refurbished into a ballroom, then a billiard hall, and even a Sunday school and polling station before becoming the San Diego County Courthouse. But between the years of the 1860s and 1870s, this courthouse became a focal point between a battle of Old Town residents and New Town residents, which is the current downtown San Diego. Thomas Whaley had offered to sell the house to the county, but his offer was ignored, and New Towners demanded that all county offices and records be held in New Town. It was an issue that dominated the local elections. It was quite a heated battle and lasted for several years of court battles. The California Supreme Court had to step in and made orders to move all county records to New Town, despite the armed resistance in Old Town, which effectively shifted the focus of the city into what is now downtown San Diego. The Whaley and Crosthwaite's General Store had the honor of being one of the first bilingual stores in the area. Sadly, in January of 1858, Thomas Whaley Jr. died of scarlet fever at only 18 months old. His death and a fire which caused them to lose their general store caused Thomas and Anna to move to San Francisco, and they didn't return to the old Whaley House until 1868. One of the ghosts said to haunt the Whaley House actually died before the house was even built. Yankee Jim was hanged in 1852 after being convicted of stealing horses. He was hanged on the property that would soon be used to construct the now infamous Old Whaley House.
So I guess, is this the archway that they were talking about?
Yeah.
These archways were where the gallows would have formerly stood.
Amongst these reporters of feeling a presence in the home was Thomas and Anna Whaley themselves. They heard sounds of heavy disembodied footsteps on the second floor when no one else was home. In January of 1882, both of Thomas's daughters, Violet and Anna, married their loves in the family home. Unfortunately for Violet, her marriage did not turn out to be a very happy one. And after many years of happiness, the Whaley family were about to experience more tragedy. Unfortunately for Violet, soon after her nuptials, her marriage would end. Some say her husband left a note revealing a sordid past that Mr. and Mrs. Whaley could not condone. And others say he just fled in the middle of the night and was never heard of again. Whichever it was, this left Violet brokenhearted. Deep in the depths of despair, Violet sadly committed suicide by shooting herself in the heart in the Whaley home at just 22 years old. Her suicide note reads from a poem: mad from life's history, swift to death's mystery, glad to be hurtled anywhere, anywhere, out of this world. Her ghost is said to still haunt the Whaley home. It was said that Violet's sister Corinne was also engaged at the time of her sister's death, and due to the scandal it raised, her fiancé broke off their engagement. In 1868, Thomas Whaley converted the upstairs family bedroom into a theater and rented it out to the Tanner Troupe, a local traveling theater group. The small one-room theater featured a stage and a few bench seatings. On opening night, it actually held 150 guests. Just 17 days after opening, the theater's operator, Thomas Tanner, died, and the troupe was disbanded by January of 1869. After these tragic events, Thomas Whaley and his family moved out of the Whaley House once again to downtown San Diego, when they would not return for almost two decades. It wasn't until 1909 when his son Francis undertook the restoration of the home. And in 1912, Anna Whaley, her daughter Corinne, her son Francis, and George all lived in the Whaley House once again. Corinne Whaley was the last member of the Whaley family to live in the home, and she lived there until her death in 1953. From all accounts, this was a close and loving family in life, and it seems that that love and togetherness continues even in death. Spirit activity from many members of the Whaley family have been reported, such as seeing apparitions of Mr. Whaley and Anna Whaley, Violet Whaley, and even hearing the little baby sounds of Thomas. Despite a lot of the tragic stories that happened in the Whaley home, we've always been drawn to this house and love visiting it every time we come to Old Town San Diego. And I'm just curious if you out there have visited this house as well, if you want to visit the Whaley House, and if you've had any experiences at the Whaley House, please share them in the comment section below. I'd love to hear it. Thanks for watching, guys. See you next time. Bye.
Hey guys, don't forget to subscribe and never miss another minute of the fun. And of course, we offer detailed destination guides and travel tips over at our blog, hotmamatravel.com, to make your next family adventure hot.